Yeah, so to paraphrase, showing that you're serious, that you really, really want to learn, whatever form that takes, just show them that you're serious. I mean, that's
And
the
I
main thing.
think a lot of times when people say, "Oh, I want a mentor." I mean, on social media, I get that every day, right? People, "Oh, Dan, can you mentor me?" Right? I'm sure, Jordan, you get people that say, "I
Oh
can
yeah. Oh
mentor you,
yeah.
Jordan," all the time, right? I think one of the best advice I could give to people is when you're approaching the mentor, keep in mind your mentor it has been there and done that. They are a few steps ahead of you, right? Or many, many steps ahead of you. They're more successful. They've got more experience. You are going to them. Don't approach them coming from a place of like entitlement or obligation where, "Oh yeah, you're successful. Help me. Like poor little me, right? Help me out." That's a very wrong mentality, right? When you approach a mentor, you should always come from a place of value. How could I solve them problems? How could I help them? How could I don't, in the time I was just helping Alan to clean up his office and doing like very low level work, right? I was licking the stamp. That was my job. I don't care because I was there to learn, right? And a lot of times I think people now, "Oh, like you're gonna teach me, I'm gonna be this." They're coming from a place almost like you owe me something, right? You are successful. They don't owe you shit. Okay? They are successful. If you want something from them, you gotta come from, and some mentors, maybe you go to their training, you go to their workshops, or you go to the online training, you invest in yourself, that's cool. Some mentors where you work for free and you get like some time from them, that's cool. Whatever it is, but it has to be that kind of relationship. It cannot be a relationship where you're like a vampire, right? You go and you want to suck the knowledge and suck the energy out of them. Well, there are a lot of people who want their time. So you got to come from a place of there to help and add value first.
Right. And I would, yes, adding value, but here's the caveat. And I got this only a couple hours ago this morning, and I get it all the time, is I really want to help with your mission. What can I do for you? Like people, you know, looking for me to like help them out and, you know, or like, you know, associate with them. And it's like, okay, now you've just given me a homework assignment. I have to now figure something out that you can do for me. And it's just, that's not the way to do it. Come with something very specific, a problem, a solution to a problem that Dan has or I have, and that will be so much more likely to result in the outcome that you want in getting that.
Exactly. It's like if you want to have that, to me, the mentor-mentee relationship is a very special relationship. Because coming from my martial art background, right? That's why all my students, they know my martial art background. They call me Sifu. Sifu means like mentor in Chinese, right? So it's that martial art example that I always use that comparison. It's a respectful relationship. It's a very special relationship. So you don't, if you're not even investing time in a relationship as a mentee, then why would your mentor invest any time in a relationship? If you have not taken the time to study like what you do and how you do it and things like that. If someone comes to you, say, "Jordan, oh, Jordan, help me out. Like, you know, I'm just a young guy. I'm getting started." Like, versus they listen to your podcast, right? They go to your website. They know everything about you, right? And versus, "Hey, you know, Jordan, I've been getting your email. I've been seeing your marketing. And I think this hypothetically, this is a landing page that you have. I have some writing skill. I think I could help you. And in fact, I have already written a brand new landing page for you. Can you give me some feedback?"
Ooh,
And
that's
what are you going
it.
to say?
Oh my God, yeah, let's talk.
Let's talk. This is awesome. Like, you're my kind of guy, right? But versus you want something for nothing. No, give first. And guess what? Very often when you give and give and give and give, you may not get anything in return. But all you need, all it takes is just one. You need that one person who believes in you. And then your whole life will change. My whole life changed, right? When I had my first mentor, then my second mentor, the $50 billion man, Dan Pena, right? So it's both have been my mentors for over a decade. That's why I think mentor-mentee relationship, sometimes people think they buy a book, they buy an online course, that's a mentor-mentee relationship. That's not a mentor-mentee relationship, right? That's you buying a course, right? A mentor-mentee relationship is you know them and they know you, right? They actually know who you are, right? They know you personally, and there's that long-term relationship. So that's what I have. That's why both have been my mentors for over 10 years now, right? And we respect them a lot.
Absolutely. I want to highlight again just so many good points here, but highlighting that do your homework on that person.
Yep.
You know, listen to the content that they have out there. Watch their videos. I think it's very lazy when people say,
lazy.
What's your story, man? Let's get on a phone call. I really need to gain some insight from you and from your story and your, where you get your inspiration from. And it's like, it's out there, man. It's out there. That's lazy.
And if they won't, exactly. If they won't even do that in the beginning relationship, how are they going to behave after the relationship? It makes no sense, right? If they won't even do that little bit of work, like, exactly. Oh, let's get on the phone. I want to hear more of your story. Are you crazy? Like, how many times I've told my story on social media, right? How many podcasts have, you won't even do that, right? Like, it should be like anyone who's serious, they have almost like look at your stuff inside and out, right? And they're resourceful enough. And maybe, like, say, Jordan is, maybe you don't need a landing page, but they keep watching you, and suddenly, maybe in on the podcast, you talk about, oh man, you know, I really need someone to help me with whatever. Just kind of mention it one line. And suddenly next day, you have someone email you. Hey, Jordan, in the last podcast you talked about, you kind of need someone to help you with this blank. Well, I don't know how to do it. I happen to know someone that I think that can help you. I would love to introduce you to that person, and just leave it at that. And now you remember that person. And like, oh, that's a nice guy, right? And from there, that's how you start the relationship. Then naturally, I'm certain you will be like, okay, thank you so much for the introduction. How can I help you? Right? You feel like now you're obligated. How can I help this person back? Because they've given you something of value in advance. It's very basic kind of business relationship and acumen 101, but common sense is not common practice.
Yeah.